Rebecca Loos had her say over her alleged former lover David Beckham's new Netflix documentary and said she was angry about his failure to take responsibility. The smash hit four-part series, entitled Beckham, has shot to the top of the charts on the streaming giant across the globe, exploring the footballer's career and his private life. The show has had more than 12.5 million views since it was released on October 4 and touches on the old claims that the former Manchester United player had an affair with Loos when she was working for him as a PA in Spain, but doesn't go into any specifics or name her. When the affair claims were made, back in 2004, Rebecca was in the spotlight with her allegations that she said took place while he was playing for Real Madrid and wife Victoria and their two sons, Brooklyn and Romeo, were back home in the UK. Rebecca now lives in Norway with her husband and two children and works as a yoga instructor. She's been out of the public eye for years, but in her first interview since the documentary dropped, she slammed the show, which was made by David's own production company. Asked if she felt resentment for him, Rebecca said, "If I'm being totally honest, yes I did. It was the most unhappy I have ever been in my entire life." The series may not mention Rebecca by name, but it includes a scene where Victoria says her husband's move to Spain was the hardest period because it felt like the world was against us. David, now 48, told the camera, "There was some horrible stories which were difficult to deal with. It was the first time that me and Victoria had been put under that kind of pressure in our marriage." He added, "I don't know how we got through it in all honesty. Victoria is everything to me. To see her hurt was incredibly difficult, but we're fighters and at that time we needed to fight for each other. We needed to fight for our family and what we had was worth fighting for. But ultimately it's our private life." A raft of bombshells came from Rebecca's interview on October 22, as writes The Mirror, which include, blame. Rebecca claims the blame has all been put at her door. She told The Mail on Sunday, "It's all, poor me. He needs to take responsibility. He can say whatever he likes, of course, and I understand he has an image to preserve, but he is portraying himself as the victim and he's making me look like a liar, like I've made up these stories. He is indirectly suggesting that I'm the one who has made Victoria suffer. He's the one that's caused the suffering. He could have simply said that this was a tough time and I don't want to talk about it." She also accused him of landing her back in the spotlight without getting in touch to warn her. Lunches with flirting on the side. Rebecca met David when she was working for global management company SFX. She'd previously met him in the office and then they both ended up in Madrid. She claims he walked past me, looked me up and down, and gave me a cheeky grin on one occasion. She met him when they'd both moved to the Spanish capital and he was standing with a friend in reception, and she said she rolled her eyes and said, "Another footballer." Soon, Rebecca was assigned to the superstar and she was given the responsibility of welcoming him to the city, which was more than 800 miles away from his home and family. The pair bonded over Spanish food and wine and went to great efforts to dodge paparazzi. She said, "Once when he was under siege in his hotel, I smuggled him out in the boot of my car because I wanted to show him the real Madrid." She took him drinking in the swanky Chueca district and shared the best croquetas in the city at a tapas place. Rebecca then revealed Bex had a soft spot for her around this time and would secretly try to hold her hand while they drove through Madrid. She also claimed he played footsie with her under the table if they were eating with his entourage. Rebecca said the flirty banter didn't stop when Victoria and the boys moved out to Spain, and she soon started helping the rest of the family get used to their new surroundings. She'd take them house hunting, helped sort out schools, and even responded to late-night requests for Big Macs to be brought to their hotel. Beckham's six-word text that sparked a fair Rebecca became so close to the family that she was even asked by Victoria's own PA to deal directly with her for their house hunting. But she claims she soon got a text from David himself, as she revealed, "When I said I'd been given instructions not talk to him about things, he said, 'We don't have to tell anyone.'" Their first sexual liaison, Rebecca, said their flirtations soon ramped up and they had their first sexual tryst not long after, and they'd go on to sleep together a further four times, she claims. She said, "I remember turning to him and saying, 'You're so lucky, you can have whoever you want.' And he looked me in the eyes and said, 'I've never done this before.' I thought, 'Wow. I mean, I foolishly fell for his lies.'" Rebecca's mom suspected affair. One person who became suspicious about the alleged affair early on was Rebecca's mom, Elizabeth Loos. The PA still lived at home with her parents, and her mom and dad, Landert, welcomed the Beckhams to their seven-bed mansion after the affair had begun. Join the Daily Records WhatsApp community here and get the latest news sent straight to your messages. She said, "When I went home the day after sleeping with him for the first time, Mommy asked, 'Where have you been? Where did you sleep?' And I just shrugged my shoulders. I didn't say anything. But she knew. She just looked at me and said, 'Be careful.'" Rebecca now says she's very sorry for what happened and how she handled it in the aftermath when she went public with her allegations. She adds that despite her tremendous guilt and the affect on the Beckhams' marriage, she wouldn't have met her own other half, Sven Krystjarskaya, had it not happened. Her husband was a doctor on the 2008 Dutch version of the reality TV show 71 Degrees North, which she took part in, and she added, "Things happen for a reason. And now I have a wonderful life with my incredible husband and children." David Beckham's representatives have been approached for a comment.